Alex, it's a big fight this Saturday night. It's fight week. Anthony Joshua is going to try and attempt to beat Alexander Usyk and win the World Heavyweight Championship for a third time. Can he do it? And if so, how does he do it?
For me, he's not going to win the fight. Don't like being negative. I don't like going against Englishmen. But I can't see him beating him. He's just better in every department, mindset, physically. You know, he's very agile, very fast. He's got it all, really, hasn't he? Very unorthodox style, hard to replicate, be hard to get sparring to replicate. I think Joshua's a good fighter. He's managed to do well from the Olympics and achieve what he's achieved. But I think beating Alexander's going to be a step too far for him. I think, obviously, he is a very good fighter, isn't he? You've got to look at the guys who he's beat down at cruiserweight. I mean, in boxing, everyone's got the punch at heavyweight especially. But if Joshua lands a good, clean, hard shot, clean, you know, you never know, he could take him clean out, yeah. But it's landing that shot. You know, and then you hear people like say, oh, he's got to put more pressure on, he's got to do this, he's got to do that. It's all easy said than done. When you're in that ring and you've got that guy in front of you, he's tiring you out. Not just physically, it's mentally. When you're boxing at this level, people think, oh, but he'll be physically fit, but it's the mental side as well. It's mentally draining, throwing punches, missing and getting caught at the same time. And the punches are always the ones you don't see coming, and that's what Alexander's good at. He throws punches from all sorts of angles. He's enjoying himself. He's got a very good mindset. To me, he just wins the fight. Unfortunately for, obviously, it's great to have an heavyweight champion. Maybe in another era, maybe guys like Lennox Lewis, I'm not sure, other fighters, but for me, Anthony Joshua doesn't beat him. I think guys like this give even Tyson slight problems. I love Tyson, but, you know, them small guys who are fast and elusive, they're hard men to beat. Look at Steve Cunningham with Fury. He was a bit of a bogeyman for Fury. I think Tyson probably even admitted it. I just think Alexander's just, you know, going to be a bit too good, and you've got to give it Joshua. Some people have never jumped back in the rematch, but he took the rematch and I was quite surprised he took it. So yeah, for me, I don't think he beats him.
How do you see it going, mate?
Usyk by knockout, six round in the six, I think, fifth or six. I think Joshua's going to come out more aggressive than the last fight, because obviously, as we know, we can't sit on the back foot and let Usyk move around in and hitting him with clean shots. So I think he's going to come forward, but I think they're going to get caught. He's going to get caught trading with him. I think it's going to be an exciting fight early on, definitely 100%, but I can see Usyk catching him and finishing him in the fifth or sixth round. I think he might come out fast early doors, try and catch Usyk cold, and then I think he might get tired. And he seems to tire after like four at a good pace. He does get a second win, you know, as we've seen in other fights, like with Klitschko, he got his second win in like the eighth or something. But I think he'll get stopped in the six. I think Usyk will catch him trading. He'll lose his shape a little bit when he's tired, and Usyk will catch him with something. I think he's put a bit of weight on as well, so it is interesting, because he might not be as fast as he used to be, you know, carrying the extra weight, but I just can't see him losing with the Ukraine thing and all that. You know he's going to be really up for it. I think it's one of them fights that Usyk can't lose, because he's got like the pressure of the country on him as well, so I just see him performing and finishing him in like 5th or 6th, so yeah.
Can he do it, and what's your opinion on the fight?
I hope so. You know, you want to support, you know, the British, and obviously it'd set up that Fury fight that we look like we're going to miss out on otherwise, don't we? Obviously, it's unlikely, isn't it? You know, because once you've been beaten once, you know, it's likely that the same scenario happens again. But it'd be amazing if he does manage it, if he pulls it off. But it's whether he's got the confidence, you know, to put it on him, you know, because he has to fight a totally different fight, doesn't he? I mean, everyone's saying, oh, if he moves, you know, if he goes after him, he gets knocked out. But, you know, you've got to put it on someone like that. You can't. I think it was the Bredis fight, wasn't it, when Usyk fought Bredis, and Bredis put it on him, and he looked, you know, he looked beatable then, he looked beatable that night, and he's obviously a different fighter now, it's a few years ago now, but he definitely, you know, he looked beatable there, and if Joshua can do that to him, then there's a possibility that he changed the result, which would be nice to see, like I say, for British boxing.
He's got the power, he's got the punch, the size, like you say. I mean, Chisora put it on Usyk, didn't he? I mean, even though he's not going to do that type of, that style, Chisora's, you know, one on his own, but
yeah,
made it uncomfortable at times. Yeah. And there was times in the fight when Joshua did have success with, you know, certain punches, but I agree it was probably the whole wrong style.
Yeah, I think, he, you know, like he tried and to do the same thing that Usyk was doing, which is up on your toes, using distance, moving in and out, and like Usyk's like an expert in that, but plus he's a smaller man, isn't he? You know, and a bigger man. You know, I know that I've been up at 17 stone, down at 16 stone, and I know that when I'm up above 17 stone, your heart rate goes up so much higher, so much faster. And if you're up on your toes, I remember in my amateur fights, my coach had me boxing like that, and my heart rate would be through the roof. You know, my lips would be blue at the end of the fight. Really didn't enjoy those early fights because of, you know, where it took me, you know, and you have to grit your teeth. You know, once your heart rate's up there, that, you know, you're at that red line, it's very difficult to fight when you're like that. And I think these days, you know, or in my later fights, that's what I was trying to do. I was trying to drag other people to the red line without me being there, you know. And that's what I see that happened in that fight. He just got himself redlined.
Totally sort of his style. Where I mean, the other thing as well, his persona in that fight was very similar to, you know, how he was in the first Ruiz fight, coming to the ring smiling and not seeming quite
nice
with
guy.
It or in the zone kind of thing. I'd like to see that change as well, I think. Do you think he's with Robert Garcia, isn't it? He's changed trainers now. So will that have an effect on his strategy? Plus, his demeanour as well.
It's got to be that he's got to change his mental attitude. And then he's talking it. He's saying he's got to go in there and crush him, hasn't he? He's got to go in there and knock him out. And he's saying he wasn't thinking that last time. You know, so he's making all the right noises, but it's all right making all the right noises. You've got to go and put them into action, haven't you? And anyone who's fought knows how difficult that is.
Easy said
to
me, ultimately, Scott, how's it
going
for you?
You'd put your money on Usyk, wouldn't you? You wouldn't put your money on Joshua. But, mate, you know, I'd love it if he did do the, you know, if he got the upset win.